this to be between 60 and 70. That's the average age of this ummah. And the Prophet also said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given all the excuses that a person needs if he gives them for the age of 60. You have no excuse if you hit 60 not to go to Jannah. You don't keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or you don't keep expecting that there will be chances. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you until 60. You have all the chances that you need to worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala in a manner that will get you Jannah by His mercy. And so He says, "Oh, the man who has it in the abdi, yawm al qiyamati salatuhu." The first thing that Allah is going to hold you to account for is your salat, is your prayer. Do you pray like a chicken? You stand up and you peck on the floor. You don't give your chance, you don't give yourself a chance to say, "Subhana Rabbi al-A'la." And think about what that means when you're saying, "All praise, glory is to my Lord, the Most High." Are you thinking, "Subhana Rabbi al-A'la"? Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. And you put your head. What first thing? Are you praying 5 times a day? At least. First thing that you're going to be asked about is salat. Your salat is good? Faqad aflaha wa najah. Then you will be successful and you will be saved. This is not a salvation to somebody else. Nobody else died for your sins. فَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ وَنَجَحَ. He will be successful and he will be saved. And if not, if his salat is rotten, that's it. No good. Didn't pray correctly, didn't pray enough, didn't pray on time. فَقَدْ خَابَ وَخَسِرَ. Then he is at loss and he is doomed. This is what our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. This is not somebody's philosophy. This is not this sheikh said or that sheikh said. This is what Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who you testify, is the messenger of Allah, which means he's trying to tell you what Allah, your creator, wants you to know. And that is so that we understand the importance of salah. That we don't take salat lightly. That we recognize that salat is our connection to the one who created us. Well, Lord, we have people right now who they take these genetic tests. They grew up in a house, but they have some doubt. Is that really my father? Is that really my mother? Was I adopted? And so they take tests to try to figure out who their real parents are. Why? Because everybody wants that biological connection to the one who was the direct cause of their existence, their mother and their father. People want that naturally. And we also naturally crave to have a connection to our Creator. That is that hole that exists in the heart. That's that void that people try to fill with so many other things. They try to fill it with drugs and alcohol. They try to fill that void with entertainment and sports and so forth. They may even try to fill that void by fighting for social justice. Anything that they think is going to make them feel good until that high goes down and they're by themselves. And then they realize, wait a minute, I still don't feel fulfilled. And that's because there's no connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah knows that we need that connection with Him, and so He obligated upon us the salat. More than any other obligation. When we talk about the rituals of Islam, zakat, how many times? Once a year. Fast and Ramadan, how many times? Once a year. 30 days. Hajj, once in a lifetime. Salat, every day, 5 times a day. Because that is what you need to stay straight. We need the salat. The salat subhanAllah. Our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said to his companions, "What do you think about a person who goes to the river 5 times a day and washes. Will there be any dirt that remains on him? They said, no, O Messenger of Allah. He said, that is the likeness of Salat. That is the likeness of Salat. Yamhullahu biha adh-dhunub. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala erases by way of Salat your sins. As salawatul khams, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the 5 daily prayers, wal jumu'atu ila jumu'ah, from one jumu'ah to the next, wa ramadan ila ramadan, from one ramadan to the next, kaffaratun lima baynahum, majtunibat al-kabair. They serve as expiation for the sins that were committed in between them as long as one avoids the major sins. And so Salat cleanses you. And wallahi, with sins, your vision gets blurred. You can't see things properly. You can't prioritize right. Because your heart is being affected by the disconnection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every sin that a person commits takes them further away from Allah. You're cutting off that connection. And when you don't, or when you're not connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can't see things properly. You don't have the right lenses on. You're looking through the wrong paradigm. And so you cannot see things properly. And that's why Salat is so important. And we shouldn't just stop. Yes, it's important. And we do it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligated those salawat upon us. But we should never lose sight of the value of salat. You see, our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, "Ukiba ilayya aqibun nisa'." He said that good fragrance and women have been adhered to me. That's something that I love from your dunya in some narrations. "Ukiba ilayya min dunya." From your dunya, from the worldly things, I love good smells, and I love women, the Prophet said something. And then he said, "Wujuri la qurratu ayni fi salat." He said, "But my enjoyment has been made in prayer." Wujuri la qurratu ayni, the thing that brings, as we translate roughly, coolness to my eyes, absolute enjoyment. It's the salat. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala mentions in explaining this, he said that the enjoyment, when we say qurrat ayn, something that brings that sweetness to the eye, that coolness, the thing that you really enjoy, that's above love. That's more than love. To the point that you don't want to separate yourself from that, whatever it might be. That the thing that I enjoy most, that there's nothing else that I would rather be doing than prayer. The Prophet himself enjoyed prayer to the point that he would tell me now, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ أَرِحْنَا بِهَا. Call the Imamah for the prayer and comfort us with that prayer. Not relieve us from the prayer, like many of us use in our language. Let me get prayer over. The Prophet did not want to get prayer over. He wanted to stand in front of the King of Kings, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And see, so as we stand in salah, this is what we should be thinking of. This is our opportunity to have a private discussion, a private audience with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that كان أحدكم في الصلاة فإنه يناجي ربه. When one of you is in prayer, he's having a secret counsel with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has the opportunity to address Allah, ask Allah for whatever he wants. You see, during the day we hit these spiritual potholes. And it messes us up. It takes us off the alignment. The alignment we stand up. And so with Salat, you know, you put everything back in place. It's that opportunity to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I think this is the most distracted generation ever to walk planet Earth. To the point that some non-Muslims say, yeah, we understand that during the time of your prophet, we understand why people were told to pray five times a day. They didn't have much going on anyway. No electricity, no PlayStation, no sports, big games, and all that kind of stuff. So we understand, but now pray five times a day. Who has the capacity to do that? And the reality is, not only do we have the capacity to do it, we need it more now than ever. And so it's critical that we recognize the value of that prayer, that we go into the prayer and lay it all in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our hopes, our fears, our reliance, that all of that is upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we feel that in the prayer. And that we raise our children on this. So many times we send our children conflicting concepts. So we get upset if they don't get good grades, or they get a lower grade than we expect. But if they miss Salat, they miss Jumu'ah, they don't pray at all when they're at school, or whatever, we don't have the same feelings. So what message are we really sending them? And you have the love. You, parents, mothers, fathers, do you not think? Do you want success for your children? Do you want salvation for your children? Because if you're not making them understand the importance and value of Salat, wallahi, you are setting them up for failure. Period. Because failure is not that they didn't get a good grade in this life, or that they didn't make the football team, or that's not failure. Failure is to not succeed on the day when you stand in front of Allah, when you stand in front of the judge. That's failure. So the importance of Salat and bringing that home. Our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, As-salatu nur. Prayer is light. Without light, you can't see. Without Salat, you will not be able to see what is beneficial for you in this life. It's just not possible. You won't be able to prioritize. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَهَذِي الْقُبُورِ مَنْلُوَةٌ ظُلْمَةٌ. That these graves are full of darkness. The only thing that's going to bring them light is your Salat. If that Salat is not right, you won't have light. People need light to cross the bridge that goes over the hellfire that leads to Jannah. Without the Salat, they won't need light. A Salat nur, the Prophet said. Prayer is light. So the question that we have to ask ourselves, and we have to be very honest about the answer to this question, and it's a question that you should repeat to yourself frequently. And that is, what do you really want in life? The Prophet asked a man that question. What do you want? Now mind you, if someone came and asked you right now, you knew that this person, they were the king of a very rich nation. They can give you just about anything you want, whether it's a $500 million guy, whether it's the largest home in the world, your treasures, they can give you all of that. And they came and asked you, what do you want? What would your answer be? We could probably think of quite a few things. There was a man, his name was Rabi ibn Ka'b, and Rabi alone tired, and he used to serve the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said, I was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that night, and I brought him his wadu. Wudu is the water that is prepared for you to make wudu. And he said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, Salat. Ask me. Look, this man is serving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet says to him, ask, what do you want? I can ask Allah for whatever you want. So the man said to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, I want to accompany you in Jannah. I just want to be with you in Jannah. That's what I want. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to him, oh, okay, Abadi, is there anything else you want? He said, who are that? That's all I want. All I want. I just want to accompany you. Look, again, what do you want? Ask yourself that question. What do I want? Do I want to be with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in Jannah? Or is it something from this dunya that I desire? And so that man asked the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to be his companion, to accompany him in Jannah. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, فَأَعِنِّي عَلَى نَفْسِكَ بِكَفَّةِ السُّجُودِ. So help me to help you by making a whole lot of prostration, a lot of sujood. Now that does not mean that you just go make sujood. It means make a lot of prayer. And so our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his norm was to pray 40 rakats every day. That was the norm of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. 17 fard, 17 that you have to pray, then 12, which are known as ar-rawatib. Those are the sunnah that you pray around your daily prayers. 2 before fajr, 4 before dhuhr, 2 after dhuhr, 2 after maghrib, and 2 after isha. That's 12. The Prophet used to pray them, and he said, whoever protects those 12, meaning that he is consistent in praying those 12, Allah will build for him the house in Jannah. And if Allah builds you a house in Jannah, it's so that you will be in Jannah in that house. It doesn't mean that the person being a hellfire in his house is in Jannah. And then the Prophet said, so that's 29. And the norm of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was to pray 11 at night. And so at the end of this hadith, that Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu was teaching this tabi, Hurayth ibn Qabisa, he said to him that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went on to say that Allah will say to the angels, look to what my servant has of tatawwur. Look at what voluntary prayers he has made so that you can bihi al-fard. So that it can make up for and complete what was deficient in his fard. So the believer doesn't stop at 17 rakats. A true believer goes beyond that, prays some extra, so that if there's anything lacking from his prayer, and the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us, a man stands up to pray, he gets half of his salat, a quarter of his salat, an eighth of his salat, a tenth of his salat, because he has no kushur. It's mechanical, it's going through the motions. But when you really feel like you're standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you say, Allahu Akbar. Don't say, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest, and then something else is greater to you. Allahu Akbar, and all you're thinking about is the next phone call you need to make. Allahu Akbar, when you're thinking about your wife, or your children, or your travels that you need to know. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. That's it. Allah is the greatest. He is greater. Akbar. He is greater than anything else. Anything else that might be occupying your mind. And so our Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam, informed us that you may pray but not get the total reward for that prayer. So we need those extra prayers that will serve as jabran, to make up for whatever is deficient in that greater prayer, in the father prayer. And the best of those prayers is the night prayer. Our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Afdalu salati ba'da al-fariḍa salatu al-layl." That the best prayer after the obligatory prayer is the prayer at night, is the night prayer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who stand devout in prayer.